The Closer Together Reducing Inequalities program is a program we established 3 years ago to address that long-term structural issue of inequality in New Zealand. And the purpose of today is to just try and give you a quick outline of what we're talking about in 2014. We've prepared this little infographic that tells that 30-year income inequality story in one picture. Here's another little graph that tells a similar story of the growing gap, simply saying where we started in 1982 and where we've got to today. And here's a brief response we prepared around the budget 2014, the reason for being here today. The mood of our country is changing. There are three really fascinating polls that show that actually 3/4 of New Zealand believe this country is unequal. They believe it is growing and they believe it is a problem. The Roy Morgan poll that asked people what's the biggest problem facing New Zealand, the issue of poverty inequality has gone from being barely 1 or 2% to being the most often named problem. This is a problem that people care about, and this is something we need to respond to. I'd like to suggest to you this is a Kairos moment. A Kairos moment is a moment where people of faith believe that the spirit is moving, that things are changing, there is an opportunity, there is some hope. Voices such as Pope Francis, no compromise, a clear voice, that an economy of great inequality is an economy that kills. But what I wanted to share with you today is just some of the resources we're preparing now for this year and sharing and been trying out already. And we really want to get your feedback, your sense about those messages and how we can share those, how we can build them, and how we can build an action plan. I mean, the very simple message that we're saying is that there's enough for everyone in this country. We just need to work out how to share it better. So what can we do together? Well, let's try and work on building that community for change. Let's try and join our forces and our networks and our messages. Let's widen that debate. We estimate within the networks of NZCCSS and our member agencies and their volunteers and employees, there's up to 20,000 people. Not counting their clients, their communities, their wider networks. If we can engage with your people, your staff, your teams, and have those conversations with your clients, with your communities, then that will be part of that call that will move the centre in New Zealand. We would like for you to offer to host meetings with your staff, with your clients, with communities. We can work out how to do that, to be able to share this message, because despite the level of concern, one of the consistent things that Max finds and we find is that people are still shocked when you see the extent of that gap that's opened up and the extent to which it's anchored into our communities. We would also like to work with the wider networks in New Zealand, where there's an emerging equality network that has sought to bring together all the groups that the like-minded groups that share a concern to reduce inequality and to act as a platform for developing, sharing and honing our shared messages. There are things like the Tech for Kids group, Every Child Counts, Rethinking Crime and Punishment, Com Voices, those kind of forums. So host a meeting, invite us to talk to you, encouraging your staff and your members to vote. The Living Wage campaign that has been running the last couple of years has been a fantastic example of how you can create a positive message to achieve change. And it's been exciting in Wellington to be part of a group that's seen 500 people have their incomes lifted as a direct result of what we've done. And we're looking to discuss with you how to be involved in that living wage movement. And there's also that symbolic thing about linking the top to the bottom, and that commitment to a maximum pay ratio is something we need to have a debate within the wider community, certainly in the business world where the gap is more like 150-1, 100-1. And also as individuals, of course, we can act. So we are suggesting, first of all, you Facebookers, get out there and get involved in the social media. The reach and the debate needs to take place. We've revamped our Facebook presence into Closer Together NZ on Facebook. Get along there. We're revamping our website to try and make the messages there easier to follow, easier to share, and also offering the opportunity, though, for drop down into the detailed evidence and the support. And we'll be working again to provide resources to help people to shape their letter writing, their messaging to communities. there are things that we can connect the dots between what happens in our community and reducing inequality. And things like no-interest loan microfinance debt relief schemes, such as Ngatangata Finance that we've been involved with, community housing projects, cooperative enterprise that creates local employment, retains incomes in the and profits in our communities. And then those community initiatives such as community gardens, all those things are part of that move to build the resilience of our communities and to overcome the inequalities that divide us. Get in touch with us and let's help build that conversation to becoming what it really needs to be, one of the key pathways to reducing poverty and to making this country a better place.